today we're going to talk about hitting. With that being said, I brought my son along, Jamie Howze, class of 2023, Redan High School. And as me as a pitcher, I'm always curious to know, how can I get a hitter out? So I'm going to be asking my son questions today just about his approach so that he can give me a clear view of actually how to approach certain hitters. All right, Jamie, with those three swings, you have the tee in the middle of the plate. What are your reasons for the tee being in the middle of the plate, and also what are you trying to do with the baseball when you're hitting?
Well, those first three swings, I'm really just trying to hit the ball opposite field, top side, top left of the cage, elevation of the ball.
Okay, so that's the reason you got in the middle? So you're working middle away right now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, with the tee now sitting on, with you being left-handed, the tee's now sitting on the outer half of the plate. What are you exactly working on? What's your approach now with the baseball?
For those who you see right there, I'm most likely just trying to put the tee in the middle, like middle of my belly button, cut my body in half, see if I can get my hands there in time, trying to get my hands out in front, so I hit the ball in the middle.
Okay.
Or left side of the cage.
Okay, good. With the now that you've adjusted the tee to the inner half of the plate, inner upper half, what exactly are you trying to do now with the ball on the tee?
Yeah, so now I move the tee inside a little bit. So usually people just try to pull this ball, but I'm trying to get my hands really used to getting inside the baseball, trying to drive this ball in the middle. If I do pull it a little bit, I don't want to yank it. At least hit the back of the net in the middle.
So basically, when a pitcher's trying to come inside on you, get inside on your hands, you're able to get your hands.
Yeah, you get used to getting my hands.
Get your hands used to getting through the ball, to the ball. Okay. So, let me ask you this: how many cuts do you take a day? I mean, how many dry swings? How many cuts do you take?
When I come in the cage, I usually take a couple dry swings. So when I come in, I go 20 inside, 20 middle, and 20 outside. Sometimes, if I don't like the swing I take, I just keep taking cuts. So I might get carried away. I might end up taking 80 cuts just off the tee work. Then we might go on a soft toss, and we'll get a bucket of soft toss. Get 82 balls in a bucket. So I might hit half a bucket actually.
So what do you recommend for kids at home that may not have a tee? Or kids that may not have a cage to hit into, what do you recommend as far as them taking maybe dry swings? How many swings a day should they take?
I mean, it's a couple of drills you can do at home. Well, because of quarantine, it's not real life. You can do like woofer balls. You can do a lot of dry swings. But just like woofer balls, you can do the small light ones, the big white ones. It's a lot of dry swings.
So how often should they do it?
I mean, this is the amount you're gonna do it in the cage. Just come outside.
Are you recommending every day, every other day?
Every day.
So you mean to tell me you swing every day? Really? That's impressive.
Take it. Uh-oh, the game in trouble. Started out small and they paying me double. Yeah, you can drip check, baby, like mustard. Yeah.
Uh-oh, you better not trust them. Rotate them all these. Don't shuffle. Money team got a whole M in a duffel.
Got a nurse that she don't like rubber. She don't know that I know she be my better. I ain't going out like no sucker. Yeah, West Coast smoking on Gusher. Yeah, Cartier watch pusher. Yeah,
I done ran up a whole lot. Yeah, I don't want to just top. Yeah, going up a whole nother notch. Yeah, can't be stuck in one slot. Yeah,
levels, Rolls Royce truck in the ghetto. Elves on the wheel, wave hello. Yeah, probably mad ain't ditto. La la la.
haha. Nah, I'm just playing, they can come out. Running up the money, I ain't never tryna run out. Yeah, police get behind me, I'ma burn out.
Smash.
How you get it before it even come out?
Cash.
How you make a million a drop?
Bad.
Track how geeked up fast. My mama don't like it, she ain't got no swag. Gonna stay with my mama, I've been in my bag. Yeah, I got it, what I had. Yeah, y'all need to give my swag back. Go against me, get hashtag. Ain't stunning that, I'm past that. How you jacket D, you are in your pants, match. Roll running, bringing these bands back. You can take it how you want.
So, Jamie, you know, you with you playing, started playing at a young age, when did the light bulb click for you to where you feel like you can understand different terminologies or you can have an approach at the plate? When did that happen to where you can correct yourself on certain things? Just say when you get in a slump.
Well, going on from when I was 11, playing with Showcase, that summer, I started coming to work with Coach JR a lot. He's always in the cage working, training, so I'm always over here. He's over there most likely. So I just pick up on a lot of things he say. Like I think for a couple months, I trained with him, and I kept what he gave to me, and I just improved on it. I watched a lot of YouTube videos. I never really had a serious trainer. Other than Coach JR, I never had a trainer. So I just really watched Coach JR. This is what my dad was telling me, watch YouTube videos. And I just really practiced on it. And going from that summer, I just gained more confidence in my swing and myself. And I had a good summer that year. So going on to, that was my 11 year old year. 2 years after that, played with Coach Charlie Corbison, learned a lot from him. And that year, I had a great year that year.
So you feel like you took off?
Yeah.
13 you?
Last year, I think. Last year was when it clicked. Uh-huh. I just feel like I had my confidence. Uh-huh. Yeah, I feel like I had everything good.
So you feel like you were more complete here when you, I guess, turned 14?
Not really when I turned 14, just when I started working with JR.
I got you. Okay. That's good, man. I'm proud of you, and I admire your work ethic, and I see the love and the passion that you have for the game. And same thing, we're trying to give, we're wanting majority of our kids in the program, everybody in the program, to be able to understand that this isn't a sprint, it's a marathon, and you have to continue to work each and every day. If this is something that you really love to do, that it's got to be in you. It's got to be a drive, a passion, something that you really love in order to get better. And I'm glad I was able to work with you today, and it's been enjoyable. Thank you.